debate that we have before the proceeding here. Ritchie Johnson, the time has come for me to be able to say a few things that I really feel about you here. So I'm sure I'll work my way through this afternoon. I'll try and speak up as well. Thank you very much for joining me here on the amazing occasion of a time that I never thought would arrive, of Ritchie retiring and leaving the authority of Evening Council. As I'll go through, it's been a complete superstar. I'd like to say it's been a joy to work with, and just talk a bit. And just to give people an expectation, we'll be asking for some barbecue comments from the audience after I finish, so just start to think about what you may be wishing to say as well. Where do I start, though, with Ritchie Johnson? With his right to reply still to come as well. Much, I think, can be understood about him when you realise that he hails from the big city of Lerwick. It says a lot to me of where he came from. Many of the tales I've heard from him over the past 8 years have been about his misspent youth in Shetland, and I think that has made him the man he is in front of us here now. And it is these foundations of his life in Lerwick and in Shetland have made him the man of the world he's become. And as we know, in 1986 he headed off to Brighton, the furthest place he could get to, go to university from Lerwick. And after some good work there, I'm told, graduated in 1989 with a BA Honours in Urban Studies. Impressive achievement there. Became a housing management trainee in Gordon District Council shortly after that, in June 1989, at the young age of 21. And I won't spoil the story he may be talking about, but the planes, trains and automobiles journey of going for an interview and then suddenly having to get back and to get all his stuff together and back to Kemnay to his new digs was something to behold as well. So quite a career he's been through since then. Housing officer, policy development for Gordon District Council in 1994. In 2002, he was then promoted to be the head of strategic development in housing and social work. 2009, director of housing and social work, so yet more promotion advancement for him, well deserved. And a period of time when he also covered being the director of education in his period as well. 2015, shortly after we had sort of launched our new health and social care partnership, which Richard had been part of, and I'll come to talk about that. He became the Director of Business Services through to today. So over 3 decades of service and public service, which I think he's really proud and should be really proud of being a part of. I've asked many colleagues about their experience of working alongside Ritchie during this time. One of the first comments I heard from colleagues were he was clearly destined to be a director, and they referred back to the role he took when he was playing in the football team for Gordon District Council as the sweeper, always at the back telling everyone else what to do. Destined to be a director. His interest in sport is evident, both in terms of taking part and spectating. Badminton, football, horse racing. The week always starts with tales of triumph and trauma from the weekend about how he has fared or how he hasn't. You really never know what to expect from Ritchie, but I have found he's been that keen. He even travelled to Ireland to go watch a football match that's been played in Scotland. So I'm not quite sure that what he came from, but that is the commitment and the extent he'll go to follow his sport. But even I know that his interest in football is only half-hearted, since he follows Dundee. Alongside sport, you may not realise that Ritchie has a strong interest in fashion. He's the only director I've ever worked with who was delighted so much about having dressed as an ice cream. Not just dressed as an ice cream, as a dancing ice cream, including white fishnet stockings, which, if you wish to, you have photos and videos to see later on such a site. Aberdeenshire Centre has still not recovered from the experience and sight of this vibrant, frilly, viscose tangerine shirt that comes out special occasions, which Richie wears, with a matching medallion, if I recall correctly as well. But his interest in fashion is so strong, he doesn't keep that just to himself. Not only is his own turnout he's interested in, it's that of other people. So committed and interested, he'll offer advice to other people whenever he can do. I think sometimes, though, he does step into very, very dangerous territory when doing this. I remember the silence that went across the whole of Woodhill House when he told Maria Walker one day that she really didn't give a flying hoot about what she wore. This is evident by what she was wearing stood in front of him. It's true. A few days later, not fearing any risk or concern at all, he compounded this to congratulate her for getting changed with the lights on. Still alive. Another steely silence across the whole of the building. And I have to also recall, and living dangerously, telling yet another colleague that it's very clear they put their makeup on while travelling into work on the bus. But seriously now, alongside his occasional flirtations into danger, I've got to say Richie's been one of the most loyal, supportive and collegiate colleagues that many of us have had opportunity and the privilege of working alongside. You mention his name, and a universal response from people is a smile. Sometimes a wry smile, I've got to say, but a reflection of some of the people from across the council, both councillors and officers, as we heard in the chamber this morning, and partners across many public organisations and community groups across Aberdeenshire, hold Ritchie in a huge amount of respect. They've enjoyed working with him, have had a huge amount of trust reciprocated both ways, and have only got good things to say about him. Approachable, friendly, supportive, but a sort of words have been used to describe Ritchie when I've gone out and asked people about it. Now that's something which I don't think is going to be universally heard about everyone, and it was universal for everybody who spoke about it. What I was going to say, we see that in how we've worked in terms of our community planning partnership, testament to all of the work over many years that Ritchie has pushed there. So I'm really pleased to respect that, celebrate it, and to recognise that this afternoon. We pride ourselves in the collegiate and effective work relationships we have in Aberdeenshire Council, between officers and members alike. And I do think that Ritchie's work ethic and ethos and his approach to work has been part of the foundation of generating and sustaining that culture and that ethos and way of working as well. So a testament to his 3 decades in terms of working here. So over those 3 decades of time, he's indeed navigated a huge amount of change and has led that, most certainly made a huge amount of contribution to communities of Aberdeenshire in everything he's done. Talking with Ritchie, one of the significant experiences of that change leadership he's been a part of was setting up the Health and Social Care Partnership and moving from housing and social work through to that new working arrangement. Clearly, excuse me, many other people involved in that work as well, with Ritchie right at the heart of it. And we stand here now with huge amounts of pride about that partnership in health and care and how it really is integrated, how it really is an exemplar for Scotland in terms of what we should be doing in terms of that work. And I know that it is testament to that foundation of leadership and work that Ritchie gave, that gave us the inheritance that Pam is now leading as well. So really great to see. And he's certainly been thoughtful in terms of that leadership that he was a part of achieving there. Similarly, if I go alongside health and care, and look in terms of our children's services and housing services. Again, nationally respected services, great inspection reports about some of those services recently. I think for me, a testament to those 3 decades of work that Ritchie has given. We shouldn't overlook that in terms of what he doesn't achieve. And more recently, as we've spoken about into business services in 2015, often the unsung heroes in terms of making the council work, lots of things happening around about a place that you don't know or understand are happening. Ritchie has been right at the heart of that. A real hard worker from my point of view, someone who's just got that really strong work ethic, gets everything done without complaint, without worry, and just makes everything tick and work around us, without us realising it. The Chamber reflecting that earlier on, in terms of that ability he has to just smoothly, without being too flat to talk and all this stuff. And talking about being unflat, and unflappable, I would say as well, Rich has played a very strong role over many years, and certainly more recent years, supporting me in terms of our public protection work as chair of the Local Resilience Partnership. We all know in this room we've had our more than our fair share in terms of weather incidents and events to deal with here. Many different occasions we've had to stand up and to respond in emergencies as well. Rich is normally at the heart of that lot, very calmly, clearly providing leadership, getting on with stuff, making things happen, and always just keeping people sighted and on track in terms of what they need to do. So a huge testament to that pragmatic, solid and steady leadership that you get from it. So from a personal point of view, thank you. He's been loyal, he's been supportive, he's been collegiate. He's worked hard, despite appearances at some time. Get things done all the time. I think he and I have enjoyed a decent working relationship. He will tell you differently in a minute. I'll get back to that in some shape or form. He's really enjoyed my cheek, the amount I've delegated to him all the time. But I do think that we have built up a good working relationship, which is reciprocated between the two of us. I really value that and appreciate it. I can do what I do without Richie being there my side doing what he does. So here he is at the ripe old age of 55, still in his prime. Track record of the career he's got in front of him, and I think he's earned the right to go and invest more time with his friends, his family, doing all the things he wants to go and do. I'm going off and having your tipple every now and then, going to the races, going to concerts, playing badminton, all the sort of things which he does and will continue to do so well. I know, we all know how important family are to him, and I think it's great to get the opportunity and the time to be able to spend more time with them. The only thing I must say, and Audrey is here somewhere. Okay, good luck. Thank you. This feels like us passing the baton off from us to you. But seriously, I do wish you good luck and to Sam Martin and Leanne in terms of enjoying your time with Richie. We're always here if you need a bit of respite care. So, Richie, I'm sure we'll see you again. I'm always in need of polling clerks, we know where you live, we'll come and find you. Come and do that one as well. We had a wee collection of cross colleagues, so I've got this to give you here with a few messages. I'm not quite sure how far £4.50 is going to go in Wetherspoons. Sure, it will do. So, well done. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
All the best in the future, and hopefully we'll see you again very soon, Richie. Thank you for everything you've done. You've been absolutely wonderful, awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed for the opportunity to speak again. And I think I might take some of the words I said before in the chamber back. I did say that Richie. But I'm sure Maria Walker and Karen would think otherwise. So certainly would not be. And I think much of Richie's misspent adulthood has been within this building. And if only these walls could talk, I think you could be here for a very long time. But I do look forward to Richie's book being published and names redacted, so there won't be much left probably. But and the other point that Jim made was he was a Dundee supporter. Well, I don't think that's really true, because that balloon's not orange, it's tangerine. And Richie has made the point of making sure that his grandchildren understand that that's not orange, that's tangerine. So I think that they've got, you know, a lot to learn really, if that's the model that they're going behind. But no, Richie, I really think that you will be sadly missed within this organisation. As I said, you know, your approach to difficult situations, your calmness. I'm sure the paddling has been going on furiously underneath the tables for a lot of us probably, but you've managed the way through that and supported all of us, but me in particular. I've spent 26 years in the company of Richie, through the political, my political journey, through social work and housing, which I was vice chair of, and then and council leader and so on. And Ritchie's always been there in one form or another. And I really can't thank you enough for everything that you've done to support, advise and guide me through that period of time. And I really hope that you have a very long, happy and successful next chapter, because I'm sure that you're not finished. And we will see you again in a different guise, I've no doubt. And I would just join the Chief Executive in wishing Audrey all the very best. I have had a rumour that she's applying for overtime already. and Mr. Wood's considering her application. But I know that, as Jim has said, you're a family man, and first and foremost, and do wish you all the very best. Safe travels back and forth to Shetland. You said this morning in the Chamber that is your home, but we're very, very happy that Aberdeenshire is now your second home, on an equal basis. So Ritchie, all the very, very best. Sincere thanks for everything that you've done, for not just for us as councillors, former councillors and colleagues, but for the communities out there. You've served them extremely well, given up much of your life to date in service and commitment and dedication to others. So every good wish for the future, and I hope that we do, our paths do cross again, but you will be sad in this.
Thanks for the speech, and Ritchie, you've been a great source of support and guidance. I haven't always taken it, I'll be honest. As you all know, you've always been there and always accepted the challenge and pushed back where you needed to push back. It's been 8 years that we've been here. We've heard about 30 years, three decades. I'll call it something else. It's almost a third of a century. But we disagreed on a number of things, one of them being the length of grass that you can kick things into to go and hide for a little while. But I was right on the last one. And the one thing that didn't arrive in time was the Flymo's trimmer. So I'll send that on to you at a later date. But you've done your time, you deserve to move on to newer challenges, and I wish you the best for everything that you do in the future. But thank you.
This is also a time for other people to be able to have a chance to say something, and I'd just like to invite the bus recipient of Makeup Artist advice to come along and share a few words as well.
Thanks very much, Jim. First of all, I'm going to start by saying a caveat. There's an unorthodox beginning to this presentation, but first of all, Mary, tissues? Sit back, my plan will become clear. Graham?
Lunch.
Twice. And I went, no way, Ritchie, no way, come on, tell me about that. So he did disclose to me what those two occasions were, but I've got those in doubt still. So I really want to kind of explore some of that. And actually, recently, he bet me 20 quid. I couldn't get up to cry.
Story,
no?
I've still got my glasses on.
Romance. E.T. Come Home?
No.
Oh, Marley and Me, The Dog Dies, for God's sake, Richie.
I don't like pets.
The Champ. Close? We're getting closer?
No.
That is officially the saddest movie in our 100 long sad movies list, The Champ. When he's trying to wake him up, wake up, champ! No, that's not doing it. Okay. So I'm thinking natural disasters, I'm thinking tsunamis, I'm thinking earthquakes, I'm thinking of that time when Shetland were cut off from the UK mainland after damage to their undersea telecom cable. And people thought it was Russia, but what did the Shetlanders think? They thought it was Orkin. even come a little bit closer, we thought, oh my god, Shetland are cut off. They're cut off. No, not even a little bit. And I thought, well, what are the other situations that really get you to bring you to tears? I think sometimes embarrassment, and you've heard about Richie's penchant for dressing up. Okay. But sometimes I've found Richie's stories to be a little implausible. Sometimes he does add arms and legs to things. And, you know, as a head of legal, Mike, I've had to go to Richie before and get him to sign documents. And I was really surprised when I realised that his name is, in fact, Richard. However, just like there's no I in team, there's no T in Richard. Where did the tea come from, Richie? So I'm a wee bit worried that he may be, he's fleeing some murky past life in Lerwick, or in some way trying to shake off in some sort of identity theft kind of past. But Richie's stories are always a wee bit far-fetched. Is that book making you cry?
It's good.
Okay, watch the screen then, because what we're certain of was there was two previous occasions, and one of them was the birth of Sam.
Aye.
Yeah, let's just take a minute. How's that one doing? Yeah. 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 I didn't know if that would work, so I tried a second one, but mostly I just wanted this one. Shocking hairstyle. Sorry about that. Respects, though.
I'm not sorry about any of that.
Great. And the other occasion is the one that's under dispute, because it does have a sporting link, and there's been two occasions on which Rich has kind of told me a different story about it. So I'm taking a few guesses, because yes, he's a Dundee United supporter. And so that can mean, was it Tears of Joy? Was it 1983, 14th of May, that day, Dens, away, at Rivals Dundee Stadium, if you can call it that.
Wasn't that another one?
Okay. I'll keep trying.
I'll save that.
I'll keep trying. So it wasn't Tears of Joy. Is it a year later, because the joy of winning the Premier League at Dens meant we were in the European Cup the following year, and the first round was at Tannadice, where we beat the mighty Serie A Roma 2-0. I got offered £200 for my ticket that night, and I didn't take it. But 2 weeks later, it all went to nothing when we were beaten 3-0 in Rome, but they cheated, didn't they? That's an official story. Not fake news. So was it either of those occasions?
No, there's a third one actually. Okay. I'll come to it.
So Audrey was probably right then.
She's always right.
I don't think it was this one, because you look far too happy in that photo with Sam, but that's your trip to the Netherlands when we were drubbed 7-0 last year by Atma.
We were robbed then too.
We were robbed. It was really close. The first 26 minutes just did it. 7-0, it wasn't that occasion though, was it?
No.
Okay, we think we know when the other occasion was, so we're going to try and recreate it.
Oh, Jesus.
Audrey's pleased to know we're not trying to recreate the birth of Sam. So you'll need, we think you'll need a raffle ticket. Has anybody got a raffle ticket for this raffle?
Yes!
You'll need a raffle ticket. Craig, you'll need a scarf.
Oh, better not be red.
It's not.
Thank you. That
feels better. Yeah. So the occasion in question, I understand, was at a Dundee United Football Club supporters event when Richie won in a raffle a replica shirt from the year of his birth, 1968, signed. And he was so overcome with joy that he cried. Don't confirm or deny that, or I'll just ruin the rest of it. So we're going to recreate that now. It's not a replica shirt, but it's an absolutely priceless stroke worthless. signed football is actually a few years old, I'll have to confess. And you probably Here's what you could have won. I'll put that there for now, because it's a raffle.
Okay.
And I need to see if he's going to cry. So would anybody like to pull the raffle, Jim? Give it a good shake.
Oh. It's green 571.
It looks like the tissues are safe, and his stoic approach to life's ups and downs remains intact. I'm never going to win that 20 quid, but anyway, it's been fun on the journey. From BSLT, in fact, all the people who have worked alongside you, Ritchie, you're an absolute topper. I'm proud to see a fellow Arab, and we wish you all the very best. That's that final bit of humiliation.
Right, Tubers, first of all, thanks very much, everybody, for your warmth. Put that together, it is fantastic to have that to take away. So it is really humbling, really. I'm not going to get too deep because I might go in there, she will get up. But I want to say a few things. In Council of Bourne, I was really kind of touching this morning. Council, I will say, so again, thanks to all the councillors and the messages we've been getting. Tons of messages, emails, and online too. I'll get a chance to read later on, so I will come back. Thanks to people online as well as in the room. So I'll come back to you. This is not going to be 45 minutes. Sorry. I walked through here this afternoon. I was actually going to find a paper like that in the folder. I'm not, are you? got him. Started in July 1999. I can remember it like it was yesterday. Just briefly, Jim alluded to it, the travel. I was at the University in Brighton, and I think I was travelling home to do like a summer job, save up and go away, travel the world with my pal. But I applied for a job in Ngururi, so I'll get some practice just on the way. Wasn't expecting to get it, housing training thing. I guess I'm into good practice, a job application, that'll be good chances to test things out. But the journey was, it was all public transport, being a driver at that time. I hold all the rucksack in Brighton, the interview was in Ngururi. But then mum and dad from Lerwick were actually holidaying with my sister in Portree in Skye. So I went from Brighton to Ngururi to Portree. I got a letter in Portree for the director at the time saying, do you want the job? So I was like, hell. So back to Shetland, to Skye. Pick up the book list and get sorted at home and then back down to Kemney. So that was the journey. So and that was 30 days. But that was one of those life-changing decisions. And that was one I said to the promise, just the way I went, things you kind of remember about that moment, there was a choice at that point, and I'm really, really glad I took the decision that I did. When I started, as a housing trainee, I was actually described as supernumerary, which I didn't know what it meant, frankly. Alan writes online, if you ever need to go live updates on definitions or information or facts, Alan gets it right away. On Google right away. So if you're in the meeting with Alan, you know someone, just ping it his way, he'll sort you. So supernumerary. So in today's world, that means surplus to requirements. So I've not seen many adverts with that in the title anymore. So for today, four themes, all of which I think have come up already, happily. Actually, it's been beautifully set up, I've said. Not planned. So, socialising. In the early days, it was the days of going out for lunch on Friday, even for a few beers, cheap as back in the day, that was the culture. How things have changed. Smoking was allowed in the office. PCs were just starting to be used, and I was a member of NALGO. If those people remember what NALGO was, it's National Association of Local Gorgeous Officers. I was on the NALGO subcommittee, social committee, and we'd be in names talking to stuff, bus trips and quiz nights and whatever. That was a fantastic time. Just at the time, and then maybe in the really smaller place, social scene was really good. So Bruce alluded to it team can log in the sites, five sites can get quite sparky on occasion. Social workers and our computer guys are fisty cuffs, it's fantastic. And then Badminton, we've got deal at Badminton this board. But Bruce said in his leaving on Tuesday, that something that's been said at half day, or that's been alluded to today again. So he said, you did all the work, got all the bruises, and I just swept up in behind you. Which is, I'd absolutely like. I saw Martin, so a few people will appreciate this. So in my eyes, Bruce was kind of Alex McLeish, and I was kind of Willie Miller.
You can use this yourself.
Yes, I do. But if you want to trade up, then he was Paul Hegarty, and I was David Neary. Kate, that's the first reference, don't you?
I have no idea.
Okay, don't get to this. And Davy Neary had this nickname called, he was called Sash, which he used to look like Sash at Estelle. He was a sweeper, so we're always kind of like a suave, good looking kind of guy, you know. I didn't get that nickname, was it? The sport helped justify the socialising and the beer afterwards. That was great, great fun. And the amount of times I missed buses from Inverary back to Kenby or back to Aberdeen, where I stayed after that, just too good a time has been had to leave. And just to reinforce the small community that is Aberdeenshire, first flat in Kemmy that I stayed in was actually where Chris and Jane White used to stay. A place called Happy Lands, just with a Chinese takeaway in between the Gushet and the Burnet, for those that know Kemmy. And the scenes you used to see in between those two pubs on Saturday night in Kemmy was far better than anything was in the telly. Carnage. So, theme two, friends and fun. So, again, it's going to come through today. Made lifelong friends along the way for a bit of a job I've been in, and that's continued right up till now. So, really, really appreciate that. In fact, one of the guys that I made friends with back in 1989, first week, went to see the races down in York in a couple of weeks' time with them. So there's still a few guys from way back then that were still in touch with and socialising with. I have threatened a few people to expect a message in the next wee while, threatening to keep in touch. Threatening in a nice way, not a stalky kind of way. So I did get some advice from Carter about what constitutes stalking. Encouragement. But although, if you're wanting advice about alcohol and trains and ScotRail trains, don't ask Karen. I'll just leave that there. I do have I call it a pint list, or a coffee list, probably will. I started with a list of people that will. I don't want to call it a hit list, I'll leave that way, but I'm just stalky again. I guess just on that basis, I will be a pint of coffee, or let me know, dead happy, I'll buy the first one. You'll notice actually that there's no cakes or coffee in the room today, and that's not just because I'm a little tight.
Members, okay.
here, actually. Sort of sprinkled around the room. So, a quick question. Name of, take that by members. You've got Howard.
Donald.
Gary. Mark. And Jason.
Tangerine.
Thank you! Yeah! Team 3, Tangerine. So, in my tongue here, I'm trying to get people to understand that Tangerine is different to Orange. Just nearly getting it, nearly getting it. And again, we're back to a lot of our legacy. So this is still Dundee United, Kate, football stuff. So just to, it's hard to differentiate between Tangerine and Orange, but if I leave you this thought around that, then just an example, you wouldn't see any bother at Tangerine work, would you? I'm not going to pursue that, that's too dark a path to go down. I was going to talk about the bully bins, but that's just, it's utterly fantastic. My powers are convincing us something to do with that. It's absolutely coincidental. So I'm delighted to see it there. I've two bits of trivia on Tangerine before I finish this and go to the final theme. Rainbow. Arabs in the room, there's a few Arabs, there's a few. Dundee United fans, I like them Arabs, just to explain. A few Arabs in the council, which has been great. But character Zibi in Rainbow, for those that are old enough to know, I'll pretend that they're not old.
It's a cheap set work off
something, right? He was going to be blue, Zibi was going to be blue originally, but Jeffrey Hayes, the presenter, was a Dundee United supporter. He insisted that he was Tangerine, so that's genuinely quite as if he was Tangerine in Rainbow. I'm not making it up! I'd rather in the Highland League playing Tangerine, which United gifted him 6 years ago. That's another story. But that's enough about Tangerine. That might entice a few more United fans. So, final themes about work. So, I guess Jim said, through all the kind of fun and socialising good times, there's been a lot of work to do during that as well. And I've always, it's come across being one for trying to keep a smile on their face as much as you can when you're working. There are some serious times and there's tough stuff to deal with, of course there is. But it's also just trying to enjoy yourself as best you can as well. And I'm massively grateful, I'd say, for, I guess, council employing me, different jobs. I've had working with so many fantastic people over the years. It's been professionally and personally really, really rewarding. And so typically how we go about our jobs with our smell, I think makes it better. You get better results if you've got a kind of good, happy team around you. Councillors, again, touching this morning, but I think again, what you do is an incredibly tough job and unappreciated sometimes, a lot of times. I think people were walking in your shoes for a week or a few days to see what it was really like. I took a massive respect for what you do. And MPs and MSPs too, a thankless task on occasions. But like always, the good times will dwarf the bad times, I'm sure, just in terms of the experience. Talking about MSPs, at an MSP and MP meeting a few weeks ago, I was speaking to what I would describe as an astute, an eagle-eyed MP. Now, she was looking across at the other directors in the room. I won't name names.
Not lies,
but you can see where this is going. And she commented that I must be the youngest director in the council. By some distance. She did say that last bit, but I knew what she meant. I was a bit taken aback because I actually had it in the notes that way. I'm more taken aback by the fact that she felt the need to even say it. So, thanks, I got the card, Jim, and it's a really generous amount of money that's been contributed to me. So, thanks for all those that contributed to the card. You guys have been here today and online today. Thanks very much. Incredibly grateful to all of you. So, just as I head towards the end, I'll be spending it wisely, ish. I'm going to sprinkle it across my four themes I've touched on today. Socialising, friends and fun, Tangerine, and work of some kind. Although that book will be a fantastic memento, so thanks very much for putting that together, brother. And just to go back in kind of full circle, so we moved from Blackburn to Inverurie a few months ago. We were Blackburn for, she was 28, 29 years. So quite a big move. So we're now back to Inverurie, back to the Overlooking Gordon House. as soon as I climbed back on the 10th of July 1999, we're back to Gordon House, which is brilliant. So that's great. And it'd be remiss of me not to say there's a couple of things to finish up with. Wendy, as everybody knows, you're the I've got two bosses in this room. Yeah, two bosses in this room. A massive thanks for putting up with me. I'm taking mine down to lunch tomorrow, so you'll catch me properly there. Gift card and things will be available then. Mine's all the garden centre, you never know. Mine's next to the garden centre. So, no, that, Wendy, genuinely thanks very much for your steady hand over the piece. And there's so many more people like Pete thank and name I'd probably miss some. But as Carol alluded to, the team at BSRT, fantastic group of folk to work with. It's friendships as well as professional relationships. That's been great. And SLT, again, has been a hoot at times. Tough stuff to deal with, serious stuff to deal with, but still, on the right occasions, a real hoot. But everybody actually that I've worked with, I think I've got something from every experience over all my years, so it's been fantastic. So, what's to say? Thanks very much. Really humbled today, and all the best to all of you in the head as well. So, thanks very much. That's it.